stick, a stone. It's the end of the road. It's the rest of a stump. It's a little alone. It's a sliver of glass. It is life. It's the sun. It is night. It is death. It's a trap. It's a gun. The oak when it blooms. A fox in the brush. The knot of the wood. The song of a thrush. The wood of the wind. A cliff. A fall. A scratch. A lump. It is nothing at all. It's the wind blowing free. It's the end of a slope. It's a beam. It's a void, it's a hunch, it's a hope. And the riverbank talks of the waters of March. It's the end of the strain, it's the joy in your heart. The foot, the ground, the flesh and the bone. The beat of the road, a slingshot stone. A truckload of bricks in the soft morning light. The shot of a gun in the dead of the night. A mile, a must, a thrust, a bump. It's a girl, it's a rhyme, it's a cold, it's the mumps. The plan of the house, the body in bed, and the car that got stuck. It's the mud, it's the mud. A float, a drift, a flight, a wing, a cock, a quail. The promise of spring. Riverbank talks of the waters of March. It's the promise of life. It's the joy in your heart. A sting, a pain, a snail, a riddle, a wasp, a stain, a snake, a stick, it is John, it is Joe, a fish, a flash, a silvery glow, and the riverbank talks of the waters of March. It's the promise of life in your heart, a stick, a stone, the end of the load, the rest of the stump.
Beforehand, I wasn't nervous at all, and the whole thing wasn't very nerve-wracking, but then it just hit me like a ton of bricks. I was sitting with the lads, and I turned around and went, fuck me, I'm getting married.
And then Jeff, the photographer, arrived, and all these shots with, like...
That was very good as well, yeah.
With Ursh being the stylist, and at one point we were, like, on a Vanity Fair shoot with me on the bed with my dress and everyone kind of around me, so that was quite cool.
Hello.
into the venue and seeing everybody's congregate and all the happiness, and then the music starts and seeing Val come down the aisle and just blow me away, which is a stunningly beautiful. Looking at her dad trying to hold it together.
Let's go down, come on down. Oh, brothers, let's go down, down in the river to pray.
The ceremony and Ant and Gretchen, how they handled it, was fantastic.
My name is Gretchen, and my husband Anthony and I are going to be officiating today. We met Bill and Belle many years ago, and in fact, they met in our kitchen. So we have the privilege.
I think in a weird way, the moments of the ceremony for me, I mean, there was lots, but Gretchen trying it for it all to be really poignant.
Thank
and emotional.
Thelma and Bill.
Togo and Wedge walking in at the back late in their outfit, these crazy outfits.
You have the...
it was great because it kind of lightened everything up. Saying our vows was great. I also kind of was happy. I kind of had big match temperaments, and I think what was nice is during the ceremony we kind of just kind of chatted to each other, so that was kind of cool. The choir were beautiful.
I love you.
You are my best friend,
soulmate and comforter. Today I give myself to you in marriage. Before all
our family and friends,
I vow
never to intentionally break the solid foundation of trust upon which our love is built.
I will give you the space you need to grow, but be close enough
to support you.
I promise
to love you, respect and cherish you
as my valued partner
in this adventure that is our lives.
For better or worse,
richer or poorer,
in sickness and in health,
from this day forward,
that is my solemn vow.
This is my solemn vow to you.
If you want to say, with this ring, I thee wed.
I thee wed.
And Val, if you could pick up this ring, it on Bill's finger. With this ring,
with this ring, I thee wed.
And after these vows and these rings have been exchanged, to declare you husband and wife, Bill, you may kiss your bride.
Can see you, we're gonna make it quick. I'm gonna give you a count of three. One, two, three, then you can open your eyes. I know it's very bright.
Setting off the sky lantern, chaos, our friends, nobody follows instructions, we've got to be one at a time, there's just like fire everywhere, Bill and I panicking because we think we're going to set Leisure Bear alive.
Wow, it's going the wrong way. It's going up. Whoa! Here we go. Your wishes.
No, it's perfect.
Your wishes. Wow.
The live one.
If you haven't already written, and then if you could maybe just make your way once this is all done in a clockwise direction back towards.
You can do it. You can do it. It's getting.
The speeches were brilliant, and I just laughed so hard, even though I was the butt of the joke for most of the speeches.
The speeches were great. My brother, I didn't realize, was quite as funny as he was. He was really good.
My name is Stefan, and I happen to be Mel's younger brother. Thanks very much for coming. I know a lot of you have come quite far. I know Mel and Bill really do appreciate it, and I know you will be thanked in due course, but thanks for making it such an amazing occasion for the two of them, and I'm sure we're going to have a very, very good night tonight. Just firstly, just again to welcome Mr. and Mrs. Corcoran. And there's just been a late thank you from members of the local community, just thanking the Irish House for the very kind donation of clothing like that. I think they saw. I actually met Bill probably about 4 years ago. And I happened to be visiting Joburg a few months before Bill's 30th. And I think 2 to 4, I probably let her know I was staying at the house as I was approaching the front door. But she and Bill had just hooked up at the time, and as it happened, Bill was there that night, and we started chatting all the rest. I woke up the next morning and Bill was there. I think he obviously left quite late that night and arrived first thing in the morning. When I woke up, Bob was stretching around in nothing but jeans. And being the younger, overprotective brother, I was a little bit taken aback by this. Since then, I really have become very, very fond of Bob. I must say, I'm delighted to be able to call you a brother tonight. And it's a huge honor. And I think the reason why we as a family love you so much is because of what you've done for Bob and the way you treat her, and I think we've never seen Belle happier in our lives, and she really is sort of shining with joy at the moment, so thanks very much for that. Obviously, after that first which Belle has obviously won Belle's heart over, I think it's the first time the Irish have won something like that, it's sort of.
And just seeing everybody out there and dancing and everybody really, really having going for a good time.
Yo, DJ, pump this party.
Were you to give Bill and Bell some advice, what advice would you give them?
50-50. Let that govern your marriage.
that's 51-49 actually.
Drink a lot of whiskey, it helps.
Get a dog or two, cook together, and have red wine every night.
Friendship, trust, love, understanding.
Just say, I'm sorry. It's so much easier. Even when you don't mean it.
Don't argue.
What was the question?
Keep the car between the ditches.
Coffee in the morning. Laugh.
Every day is a new beginning. Wake up and say, I love you. It's fucking awesome.
I don't think they need my advice very much.
I have no idea. I think I'm gonna ask them for advice.
Bill, wash the dishes and help in the kitchen.
Listen to Velma, she's always right. And even if she's wrong, she's right.
You guys don't change a thing. You got the formula right and I'm jealous. And I hope to one day have the same beautiful relationship.
Bill, if it's tugging, let it go.
Good luck, Bill and Val.
Good luck, Bill and Val.
Good luck. Feel very sorry for you, Val. And best of luck in everything now.
Best wishes. Mwah.
Good luck, Bill and Val.
Okay, good luck, Val and Bill. I'm sure you're going to have a great marriage.
Bill and Val, love you guys. And all the very best. Your future life together. Love you. Mwah!
Good luck, Bill and Val.
Bill and Val, I wish you every happiness you both deserve. Good luck, Bill and Val. Bill and Val.
Good luck, Bill and Val.
Bill and Val.
Bill and Val.
I think that's enough now.
Just thank you very much for everybody who came from so far and came to our wedding and made it really, really a very special weekend.
Wouldn't have been the same without you.